Welcome, everyone. Welcome back to the Bunker Podcast. I'm your host, John, and I'm joined with my co-anchor as usual. How are you again?
I'm fine,
Will,
thank
my
you,
guy.
Mate.
Good. I'm glad you're feeling good today. We've got a guest that we're excited about. He's a very special, very talented Sheffield Gram MC. He's coming out this past couple of years or so. It's AC. How you doing, my man?
I'm doing good, man. It's good, a pleasure, man, to obviously like come down and
thank
see
you,
what you guys are about and kind of get down and tell a bit about who I am and what I do. Yeah,
we're excited, man. You've been you got one of the more interesting flows I've heard in a minute. You've been putting out some good music. Music is exciting to see, dude. Tell me about where your story starts, you know, where you grew up and what life was like for you growing up, I suppose.
Yeah, in terms of growing up, originally from like opposite side of Sheffield, like sort of Shire Greenway, and then kind of moved over to Walkley, like with my family, for like better things, because it wasn't the best kind of area. We had like a lot going on when we were there.
Okay.
But moving across to Walkley, like this is where I kind of like came into the person that I am, like developed, like met a lot of friends, you
sure,
know,
sure.
From like literally I moved there when I was probably like 3-4 years old. And then from there, a lot of the people that I was surrounded with and grew up with are the people that I still speak to today and kind of, you know, engage with on a regular basis.
For sure. So you feel as though you had like, you had a few years like growing up somewhere different to what you maybe consider as your more natural surroundings now.
Yeah.
Do you feel that gave you like two different perspectives on like the world and stuff growing up? It gave you a more, I don't know, a balanced view, I guess I want to say, if I'm on the, along the right lines there?
Yeah, definitely. I'd say one, you know, in between both places living there, like things were so different. We were a lot closer to my family, obviously, when I moved to like living Walkley Way, things like that. When I was there, we were obviously a bit further out, and like just in general things started to improve. And I was only young then, to be fair, but my brother obviously saw a lot of the stuff. But like once we'd moved kind of there, we were literally around the corner from like most of my family, and then on top of that, my friends literally lived on the next roads up, like across, so it was like a walk through or a BMX bike up or whatever, just to kind of catch up and chill.
So you had like good people around you, supportive people growing up. What got you, what first got you interested in music then? Do you feel as though your environment kind of encouraged you, I suppose, to like follow something creative like that, I guess?
I would say that as well. Like a lot of my music to begin with anyway, when I started to write, was very much focused on experiences that I've had. But if like in any of my songs that I write, there's always a story behind it. It's always something that's happened. So I'm never gonna write about something that didn't happen, or you know, chat and just say bars for the sake of it. There is a story. So if anyone asks me any question about any of the songs, I can say, oh, this was this point in my life where I talked about this. My first thing I did, like freestyle about my family and growing up and how my relationship with my dad was, and you know, how I kind of progressed on through to doing what I was doing and doing uni and like moving into music. But like a lot of that, like so many different kind of things, you know, it opened up for me, music. And a lot of it is literally just like me expressing myself, you know, based on things that I've been through or experienced. Yeah,
so that idea of authenticity and putting something out that you feel is going to connect with your audience on a personal level, that's something that's important to you in your music.
I'd say 100%. Like a lot of the stuff that I've written, when I first started to write and I wrote the stuff and I wrote a little freestyle about my family and my dad, I had people coming up to me when I was on nights out saying, you know what, you really helped me through this thing. I've been in that situation. Someone started crying to me and I was like, what? Like,
yeah,
you know what I mean? Like, I can relate to that. And I was like, oh, wow.
And you're sort of like, me, my little old song affected you so deep. I bet that means a lot.
Yeah,
that's
this is it. So, and then I've got other people coming saying, oh, you helped me through my university thesis. I was listening to this song and, you know, I was relating to this and this helped me motivate to this. So for me to kind of hear that, that's what spurred me on to say, I'm obviously doing the right thing. At the same time, I understand music's music and people want to make music and they want to make the track that hits and they want to make it like club worthy and it has to be this and this and this.
Yeah.
And I like to have fun with music, but at the same time, I don't want to lose who I am, in the sense that I like to write truthful stuff and I like to write, you know, stuff that people can actually relate to, or when they're going through something, or if they're in the gym and they're going, do you know what? Mindset, I want to kind of progress, I want to do these things, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
Just that banger. Don't get me wrong, I like to write stuff and I'll write bassline tracks and I can do all that sort of stuff as well. But again, experiences.
You got to discipline yourself.
Yeah,
to be able to do that and write that's the way that hits home.
Yeah, it's your motivation. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely.
For sure. You're like that word actor, that's a very good word, motivating. I do find your a lot of your music very motivating. I think a lot of your early stuff is very, very up tempo, it's very grime in its purest sense. Your influence might have, for me personally, there's a lot of music that I really like back in the day that I don't listen to so much now, and vice versa, stuff I didn't really get at the time that I really enjoy now as an adult. But with regards to that early stuff, what influenced that early sound of yours, and who were some of the artists that inspired you to sort of mould your sound to what it is today?
I'd probably say, to begin with, obviously just listening, like back to being in school, we're talking like obviously years, the Sheffield sort of grime scene, like Scumfam, hearing all those people come through, and like all of the different sort of like talent that's within them, you know, the people that can literally spit, they've got the Midas flows, they've got the Midas bars, and lyrically they've got some of the best lyricists that are going, and kind of seeing how they developed, and you know, listening to them like with my friends and just kind of watching it, and like obviously even down to like years back, we'd literally sit and watch like Lord of the Mics and stuff like that, so we'd all get together, like whether it's before a night out or whatever, we'd put some clashes on, we'd drink like have a drink and just kind of literally just take it all in, and we learn a lot from that sort of stuff of how things are, even down to like listening to like Don't Flop and all that sort of stuff, like when we used to mess about just rap battling each other for the sake. I'd say that taught me a lot about flow, you know, sort of delivery and kind of how to be, and even from that, obviously my first thing that I did, the freestyle, was like a hip hop track, so I've gone through stages of like, oh, I'm doing hip hop, I've done some grime, I went back to hip hop, and I was like, right, I'm going to try a few different things. So I've literally, you know, gone out my way to kind of sample and see what I can do, and kind of, you know, give what I can give, because I know I'm not restricted to just one box, I can do a lot more sort of thing.
I think you really see that in your EP as well. I think your EP is very eclectic in the sense of like, you start off with a more softer kind of musical number about a relationship, but then you go more into that US influence boom bap kind of style, and then you round it off with that kind of throwback 2000s garage kind of style, and like you finish it off on something a bit more grimy and a bit more traditional in the UK sense. I just thought that was like a showcase of your versatility. Is experimenting with different sounds, trying different things, that sounds like something that's an important concept to you, something that you want to get across in your music about yourself, you know?
Definitely. I think, like you say, you've like hit the nail on the head. It was very, when I came to releasing that, I was like, what order should I put this in? I don't want to go in too hard, and I don't want people to think, oh, this is literally this sort of music, and it's like, oh, it's going to be a bit much for me. So it was very much, let's go into it with this track to begin with. I think it's quite light and easy to take in. Then let's go from there and start to build a story and build a narrative. And then from there, let's have fun. So there was, you know, the grime stuff, the bassline, the upbeat stuff, and then there was the like serious stuff where it kind of slowed down again and then kind of finished on a high sort of thing. So I spend a lot of time, I'm like, I do tend to think a lot about stuff, especially when it comes to music and how it's going to be received, in a sense that, you know, when I see stuff come out and I hear things and I'm seeing the promotions that are done, I'm learning all the time, and I know at the same time, like, me and my friends always say this to each other, like even my friends at Spit Bars, all that sort of stuff, is when it comes to music and you've got grime MCs and you've got, you know, lyricists and stuff and battlers that will battle on grime, there is a lot of them that can, you know, hold a tune and release an actual tune and release a song that's going to, you know, be a big hard hitting song.
Going to resonate.
Going to resonate, and there's a lot of them that are some of the best lyricists you've scene period, but there's this thing that we like to call an MC's MC. We can take it in because the way you listen to bars, we think, fuck.
He's hit this and that flow and
the punchlines come there. Other people, and I'll play it in front of them, and they go, oh yeah, the tune's good, cool, the beat's good.
And that's the worst
kind of thing that I could feel to receive from the music is the beat's good, bro. Where'd you get, you know?
It means they're overlooking like what you're doing.
What is actually there. So that's why it's so important to kind of reach out to all these different levels of people, especially when delivering like a piece, like an EP, to kind of hit as many boxes as I can.
For sure.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Do what I can do. Yeah.
It's a, that phrase that you use, the MC's MC, that is something that people used to say about MF Doom, your favourite rapper's favourite rapper. Because like,
this is it, yeah.
Yeah, because like the thing with him, he made it like unbelievably technical, unbelievably musical, but it's not easy for like just anybody to get into. You've really got to study it, and then you realise like, oh, like he's teaching people what an offbeat flow is like supposed to be, if that makes sense. And once you see that and once you appreciate that, it's like you start seeing a whole different light. You're like, oh, this guy's great, but you know, it's not that kind of thing. It's not going to be for everyone. That, you know, he goes out of his way to do that.
That's the thing though, with that sort of stuff, when I do listen to these artists, it's not to say that I think they're shit or I think there's anything, you know, they're substandard. A lot of these can sing and can release music, but when you're spitting bars and you're spitting lyrics and stuff like that, is it going to get played on the radio? And this is what I think when I'm releasing songs.
Sure,
could this be this sort of song? Could this be this sort of thing that could pop? Could it be that sort of thing? And I know that there's a lot of artists that we've grown up listening to for years now that have done all the sorts of clashes and done all that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
And some of them are the best lyricists probably worldwide. Like I'd literally put it hands down and say worldwide, but they're not where these other artists that have come
up and they're
spitting about nice bags, nice this stuff. Do you know what I mean?
Sometimes like simplifying it and like someone like Lil Pump kind of dumbing it down a little bit. Like, yeah, as like someone who's like, you know, a rap fan, I've been listening to this type of music since I was like 14, 15 years old. So a long ass time, like a decade really. So like, I obviously like have from the outside in, it's easy for me to approach it in my head and go like, oh, like, bars and lyrics, that's the most important thing. But I think at the end of the day, like what he's done is he's attracted a whole new like different audience by doing what he's doing. He's dumbed it down a little bit, but you kind of got to like respect that. Like his tunes bang, you know what I'm saying? People get behind them for a reason, even if it's not technical or like this and that. People enjoy it for a reason, you know?
This is like how we are. Me and my mates are like some of the best artists that we've seen like growing up that we listen to all this time. People like Dialect from like, you know, his battles that he does. But not only the battles, when he's actually, if you've heard him sing and how he is, and he can make songs like it's nothing. He's not just like a barer. He's got this other quality to him. And then like other artists that we see growing up as well, like through Scumfam, like I'd say hands down one of the best lyricists that I know anyway that's come out of Chef, Milks.
If you ever sit
down and listen to his music and break it down, it's ridiculous.
How it won't get the airtime like a lot.
These guys, they smash it. Like we, like I know for me anyway, I've always strived to be like them. I've said it in songs before, what they do. And, you know, they know all these big DJs now. They go down to London, they're on the radio, they get these things. So, you know what I mean? If I can be anything or be close to what they're doing and how they've kind of, you know, come up, then I'm good with that, man.
There to be followed, man. Someone, you know what I mean? It's like, we got to take these things and like, people like you have to take these things and like learn from it and like, add your little bit,
this is a little bit
that's different onto the end of it. But like the blueprint's already there for you to follow. Like we're in a generation now where, you know, I don't want to say easy. It's never easy, but like, we're encouraged to kind of want to chase these things. Like, you know, we live in a generation where we're kind of empowered to, if that makes sense, you know, and like follow these examples. Are you enjoying being booked for like gigs and live shows and stuff? You were talking to me about Tramlines a few years ago, and tell me a little bit about like your fans at shows and like did they get turned up for you? What are they saying?
So in terms of like what I've done in the past, most of my like performance music based stuff was when I kind of was starting out, and I used to do a lot of stuff like, you know, playing guitar and playing drums and stuff and playing in bands, and that's like the foundation of what kind of led me on to this, you know, role of actually starting to write more and actually record as opposed to just messing about and spitting bars. But started out playing at a few different places, a few venues like West Street Live in Sheffield, like Plug, green room.
Yeah, sure.
And
yeah.
kind of, you know, just kind of sampling and going around. And what that created was a lot of networking. So even down to the music that I do now, there's people that are there that are, you know, putting everything they can do to kind of drive out the Sheffield talent and bringing people in from all different areas. So one of the guys that kind of has done so much for the scene anyway, not just in terms of hip-hop or grime or, you know, rock music, everything, he caters to everything, is Matt Hume. That guy does everything for, you know, everyone, whatever he can do to kind of help people and, you know. I've seen recently the guy, he's even helped some guy get into like his ideal sort of career and things like that. So having those sort of connections to begin with is amazing. So to the point where I'm going now, I want to do some more performances. I did like a bit of a my cousin held an event for a charity of his, and I did like a bit of a performance, like impromptu, just kind of got on and, like, you know, people connecting, people were dancing, and when I came down, I was like, wow, that's crazy, like, I need to check you out, what's your details, what's your stuff.
So they saw the talent. Sometimes, like, they can maybe hear a song, but they'll go, oh, that's good, but then they see the person live and it's like, oh shit, this guy's mad talented. They make him they'll appreciate you in a whole different way.
We've done, like, you know, I've done a few things. I even did a little bit as well, a while back now at West Street Live, in terms of like doing some hip hop, some grime, performed a few tracks, all sorts of stuff, you know. A lot of the stuff that I kind of write, I wrote a track called Perceptions, I performed there, which is like all about kind of people's take on things and, you know, how people are from different races. A lot of me and my friends are from kind of different backgrounds and all that sort of stuff, so if you saw us together, everyone's different kind of thing. So that track was all about kind of like how diverse it is and how we are and stuff, and how sometimes it can be perceived by other people and how they can kind of have a certain outlook on stuff. And it was interesting to kind of perform that one, and we all kind of performed it. And then after that, there was a few people who were like, umming and ahhing about, oh, if that should be. There's a lot of controversial stuff. And I was saying, well, if this gets people talking, then fair play. Like,
thing as bad publicity.
This is it. So,
yeah, you got your eyes set on the ball, man. Yeah. You got the right outlook on it going into it, for sure. What were your like aspirations when you first came out, I suppose, compared to where they are now? And would you say you've achieved any goals since you first like started making music?
Yeah, definitely. I'd say when I started out, it was very much people were saying to me, look, I featured on tracks. Like, I started out just like, obviously messing about with my mates. One of my closest mates, he was random, and we would literally just like mess about, spit bars and stuff, and he was saying, yo, let's do a bassline track. Yeah. So we wrote a bassline track, and this is before I'd even put out anything in terms of like grime or hip hop wise anyway. Yeah. Once we did that, we was like, let's do a video for it. Yeah, man, let's do a video. We filmed a video, got a GoPro, and we went out and we did it and like smashed it. And, you know, once we did that, we were like, right, okay, what can we do from here? And he sat down and he said to me, he's like, bro, I really think you should do a lot more with this. Like, you're a lot, you can do a lot more than you think.
Yeah, sure.
And he was like, look, write a tune. He goes, obviously we've done this, but like, start writing some of your own stuff. Cause I know when you freestyle, you can't have some crazy stuff. And I was like, all right, man.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll kind of go from there. And I was like, I took it on board and I was like, let me get this, right, how do I do all this stuff now? I need to book a studio. I need to do this sort of stuff. I need to work out how I'm going to do things with a video. And that's when I started to network with people that I'm so close with still, like, you know, Lawrence Ellis, like that guy, all his visual stuff that he does, and he films for Coco now. And when he was starting out, he said to me, I saw him a few weeks back, and he was like, listen, bro, like, I appreciate you've looked out for me. Whenever I've needed artwork or something sorting or a video, he's come to me as well. And he said, you know, like, you were one of my first videos, so I remember that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
And I was
beautiful.
Like, look at where you've gone now, and he's got a track that's got like over 6 million listens on Spotify and over a million views on YouTube.
And that's
video
just one of your peers. That's just some guy like, that was like messing about with you on a few of the
this
tracks.
This is it, and it was all about like networking, and then from there, trying out different studios, learning different styles of how people work.
Just
and
learning
More. Recently, and for the longest period of time, I've been working visually with my cousin. He's called Dan, and he has literally started out, he's done photography, he can do videography, he can do editing, he's got a drone. He's a whiz with any of that stuff. So when it comes to like a lot of the visuals that you'll have seen that drop, he's done a lot of that for me.
Yeah, yeah.
All the sort of freestyles and kind of a lot of the music videos where, you know, we've kind of sat down together, storyboarded it, and he'll say, right, here's my take, and I'll go, well, what do you think? Yeah, I think, should we try this with it? And it's good to kind of have that engagement between them.
Definitely.
Because at the end of the day, it's a piece of work that's both of yours.
Sure, yeah,
and I say
yeah.
It's just as much yours as it is mine. So, you know, with any of the people that I work with, you tell me what you think as well, because at the end of the day, I might say something, it might be shit, but like, at least you can give me your opinion, and we can kind of be real with each other about it. Yeah.
Discourse, that idea of like discourse.
Mm,
It sounds like you've got a lot of good, reliable people around you. You see their success, and that motivates you to do better. Like you, and they probably see things in you, like talent in you, that maybe you don't rate yourself for, or like didn't see before, and they've helped you bring that out in you and be more confident in your own abilities.
Like, even down to being in the booth, and I'll be like recording something, and I'll do something. I'm like, I can be really like criticize myself and go, I can do that better.
Sure,
and I'll listen to it, and I'll be like, yeah, I definitely could do that. And then I'll listen in, like, where I kind of record, like, primarily now is like Premiere House, and like, it's like a lot of the guys at like Audio Phase, all that sort of stuff. Those guys, like, have always like been, you know, more recently my main thing for like engineering for anything, and they can do beats and they can do all that and visuals as well. And I'll literally sit down and I'll be in the booth and I'll say, what do you think? And they'll literally give like constructive criticism, but I don't take it as, oh, they think I'm...
You've got to learn to take criticism,
one, and they'll say, bruh, nah, I think this could sound better this way. And we'll sit down, like, when it comes to, like, you know, post, obviously recording it, and we're sat and they're putting effects in, right, I put a stutter on this, I put a little stagger on there, I put this way, and I goes, bro, that sounds sick. Keep doing what you think. I'll sit here, obviously, but, like, you know what you're doing at the same time, you know what I mean? So, these guys are wicked, so, like, obviously... Anyone needs to go studio, go shouting. But like, honestly, like, I've learned a lot from them as well. So
You're shouting out like you got to shout out their talent as well.
Yeah,
they probably
yeah.
like supported your talent and put you on. Like, you've got to give them a mention as well. Say like, these
hopefully,
guys
yeah, I'm hoping
know what to. They're doing. You know,
this is it. Like I've said to them as well. Like, hopefully, because there's quite a lot of them. Like a collective, and I'm hoping to get some work done with them. Soon in the sort of like near future,
nice.
To get something in the works that way, so to get a few more collabs out there as well, yeah, definitely.
Sure. Like you, do you mind if I like recite one of your lyrics?
Go for it.
Back to you, because I've done my homework. On your 2020 track Fighting, one of your lyrics is, needless to say that you're going to keep on providing. I assume you meant for like the people around you and stuff, like people who supported you, obviously, right?
A lot of it, yeah. So that track is very much like, I'm gonna keep doing this. I'll keep providing what I can, you know, what I can bring in this message. But also, a lot of the sort of stuff was, I'd gone quiet for music for a bit, and it was all, you know, I lost my auntie and then I lost my granddad within sort of like about 6-7 months of each other. Like,
oh, that's
and
tough.
That was like, right, okay, big blow. Because I'd literally just got back to music again after losing my auntie, and then it was like, right, okay, I'm here, and I keep on, right, okay, what can I do? And it was all that, like, how can I stay positive when I'm feeling opposite?
Yeah.
I got knocked down in the round, but not down for the count when I fight like Connor did. And all of that, like, message of, like, you know, like, I got knocked down in the round, all that sort of stuff, and being down like Mike Tyson. Down like Tyson Fury when he got back up. That whole like message of,
because life is a fight. Obviously, you're using like the boxing analogies as a metaphor, but like these emotional things that we have to go through. Like, it can feel like a struggle, like you're getting punched in the chest or the face time and time again.
Was like, at that point, I was like, what do I do with music? Do I carry on? And it was very much like, people asking, where have you been? What are you doing? And I was like, life has just been like, I've been doing life, it's been nuts. So it was very much like, where to go? And I went back to the roots of where I started, in saying, let me just literally go to the basics, let me write how I feel, and then let's see where it goes from there. And then it kind of built up into that, and then I was like, right, what should we call it? And then literally it just like kind of came to me, and I was like, right, Fighting, okay, cool. And then and that's where it kind of developed. It
sounds like you're creating something really positive out of like a really tough, difficult situation, and like like I got like a high energy kind of motivational feel from that track, but it, like hearing you break it down for me like that, now I know a bit more of the backstory. Like, it's even more so. It's very, very inspiring.
I think it's like a lot of people are very like, when it comes to music, some people anyway, and I used to, there was a point in time where I kind of went away slightly, and people saying, yo, be true. One of my mates said to me, he's like, bro, that stuff when you talk about your life and your family and all that sort of stuff, he was like, the reactions I got initially from when I did it, because I was like, I'm saying some shit here, and like, there could be a lot of like, and I'm putting this out to the world.
And
my family to be like, whoa, what's going on? You know what I mean? And it could be received a certain way.
Yeah.
But, you know, so many people reached out, even people in my family saying, you know what? Yeah, fair enough.
That's
what you said. Yeah, that, okay, keep doing what you're doing. So, you know, to go through that and my friends say, give them that self, that, as he says, authentic, like, be you,
vulnerable,
you know what I mean? Give them
that
as well.
Fully, yeah.
Like, and there was a point where I was like, should I put, like, all this stuff and be as real and be as open as I am, like, when it comes to music? But then I was like, this is, you know, what I do, rather than it being some fake, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's hard. It's often really hard
out. I kind of, especially in that more vulnerable state, I was like, should I be sharing this information? Should I be like, this is very fresh and very new, you know what I mean?
Mm.
Yeah, but then when it kind of got out, I was like, this, what I've done and describing the relationships that I had and, you know, what these people meant to me, you know, like describing it even into like chess pieces and saying like, you know, king, we lost queen.
There's little metaphors you've got to look for, and all that sort of stuff.
And I was like, I know for me, I've done everything I can do and I've done justice to these people to say, you know, you meant this much to me and that's my piece. Do you know what I mean? And I can say, look, I did this. And I've had people reach out and say, you know what, like, my cousins have gone, you did that for my mum, you've done that, like, that's like, and people for my granddad,
the thing is, people are all, they will always gravitate to that, what is real and what is true and what is authentic. So like, you might think like, oh, is this a side of myself that I really want to put out there? But like, a lot of the time people will actually buy into that stuff and, you know, buy into it more than they would do something that maybe is a bit more superficial.
I think,
you know, something real.
That's it. And I feel like you start to remember that at the end of the day, you're a person. And like, as much as I'm like, oh, this stuff's happening, they see me as, I'm just this, like, you see an artist, they are a person at the end of the day. They've got a family just like you have, and they've been through stuff. And then that's when I started to go, oh, I'm just being daft. Like, it is what it is. I am who I am. So let me just do that and reflect that. And if people want to listen to it, then cool. If you don't want to listen to it. At the same time, I used to be like, very much like, right, let me see the views, let me see the comment, let me see what this is.
Now it doesn't matter as much.
Like, if you play it, cool, you played it anyway.
I reckon you'll find that you'll have more success with that outlook than you would do if you were like,
I think it's that,
checking for it every day, bro.
I feel like that's it. Like, a lot of the start was very much, how's this being received? When I first started putting the pieces out, I was thinking, comments on videos, what they're gonna say, or what are they gonna think of stuff? Are they gonna say this is a certain way? And even if there was ones, there might have been ones where they say, oh, this was good, or that like, there's a track where I had a bit of watch, oh, that then you're a lot better, you don't need that, stuff like that.
And I'm like,
okay, I'll take that one. But like, fair play. Other stuff where, you know, people just talk stupid stuff, and I'm just like, cool, if you've got the time to leave.
I bet that's the 1% though. I bet 99% is actually like overwhelmingly positive generally.
It's very low, and it's like, you know, if you've got the time, take the time out of your day to actually comment
to
and say something like that, then
what's going on there?
Well done, you.
There's too many of these people around, enough time. They've got too much time on that.
I've learned from a lot of people. That button's been clicked. There'll be
way more people who rate you than people who don't. What's next for you? Where are you going next, and what do you reckon the next step is in your career? And is there anything you want to say to people who like your music, your supporters?
Definitely. I'd like to say, like, obviously thanks to everyone that's kind of supported, like, throughout the years. I've got people that are kind of solid with me that have been through, like, since I started out, and they were like, bro, you remind me of these people, like Bugsy Malone or this person, keep doing what you're doing. And kind of like, each time I've released stuff over the years, sent me stuff like, and gone, bro, that's amazing, like, sending feedback. oh, what have you got next? And always asking me, bro, can I get this song? Can you send me this one?
Yeah.
Are you able to send it to me? All right, then I'll send it.
Yeah, it was a little favour for like my pal over there.
I respect that so much. Like, you know what I mean? Like, where I kind of want to take it as well is, obviously, just keep developing. What I've done over the years more recently is just worked on developing the flow and switching the flow up. If you listen to any of my first stuff, or when I did the stuff that's like on my like Facebook page like years ago, the one about my dad, that sort of freestyle, it's very much like double and single syllables. And then if you listen to my stuff now, you'll see the development, and then you'll see the flows change, and then you'll see the hooks, and then you'll see the ad-libs, and then you'll see all that sort of stuff coming.
Yeah.
And like the personality actually start to come through.
Sure.
I want to obviously drop a few more pieces. I've got a few collabs that I'm wanting to do with people.
Cool. Anyone you can like give any like clues about, or are you keeping those cards to your chest?
I'll drop some pieces. I'll drop some names, because these people, like, you know, I've worked with these people, either like studio wise and they've like helped me out, or actually on tracks before. So one of them is Random. So we've done two tracks together already, and like we both said, it's very much when it's the right time. What's the point in forcing something? Sure. Just because you're friends with each other, it doesn't mean that we've got to kind of force a piece out and it sounds...
Yeah.
It gets there when it gets there. So that's
what we said. There's not a time on it. We've said to ourselves, should we do a same old part three, and how are we going to look at it? But what we both kind of agreed is we're not going to kind of force it. It'll just fall where it falls, and it's going to be what it's going
to
be.
It has to be.
Otherwise, it's not, again, it's that authenticity. If you feel as though you forced it, that like authenticity isn't as there as much as you want it to be. But if you wait till it's right, then again, it all feeds into that idea of it being more real, more authentic.
I think that's it. Like, how we are is we can be like give feedback to each other about stuff, and we like it's constructive, and we can both say it, and we'll both ask stuff either way, whether it's been for a video or it's been for certain things, and we'll sit down and we always review stuff. Like, either us record a track or whatever, and we're out, like, it's always a good feeling once you've just recorded a track, and you want to go out and you want to like say stuff to each other and go on nights out with your mates, and we'll sit there and we'll have what we call the car test. So we'll literally the track's freshly recorded, been mixed or whatever, and we'll sit in the car,
genius,
play it, and we've just got to like engage and see what it's like.
That's
and like
sick,
do you know what I mean? And like, even aside from Ra, like obviously like people like Cade Online, Young Arts, all those sorts of people from my studio, obviously to do stuff with them as well. But literally I'm open to kind of stuff. I've had people reach out in the past and say, you know, can you do a verse on this, or can you do this to me? Obviously worked with Tez Kid. It'd be nice to kind of work with like Scum Fam, do a little bit more work there and see what's...
You're the kind of guy that, hey, if you need me, I'm here. You like to be like useful music, like whoever's around you as possible.
That's it.
You know?
I like music, man, and like if people like dig the stuff that I do, and you know, a lot of the reception I've got is like, bro, you're crazy, like, what, you know, all that sort of stuff, and that's like, I take it on, and like, I'm very like, I like to be very humble. I don't like to like rant and rave about me and be like, oh yeah, I'm sick, I'm this, I'm that.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I'm like, oh, appreciate it, man. Like, but if you check this artist out as well, like, this person's helped me out with this sort of thing.
Any bit of clout you get, you like to give the rub to someone else as well.
It ain't just me, because if it was just me, I'd just be stood on the street spitting bars.
No one can do this shit by themselves.
So many people, man. But there's literally so many different things. And like I've said, I've obviously worked with people in Sheffield. It'd be nice to maybe expand stuff and reach out and like obviously work with people from different areas as well. So
yeah, for sure. You sound like you've got a lot of grand ambitions, but like if you've got your eyes set on the prize, I think you're going places, man. Do you? That being said, do you have any new music coming out? Where can people find it? And is there anyone else you want to shout out before we have to go while we've got time, I guess.
In terms of music, I've got a track that's going to be coming out at some point soon. Can't say just yet, because there's obviously the whole giving it to the distributors and all that sort of stuff, and obviously visually and getting the visuals all sorted. That track is called Spirit, so it's literally all about kind of like my background, like where I came from, like where my family's from anyway, and all about like kind of music, but it's very like very upbeat. It's not like serious. It's like bars, flyers. Yeah.
Like, so, stuff for people to enjoy. It's food for the masses. Yeah,
that's going, it. Going so there's a lot. You know? There's a lot of fun to it. Nice. Very upbeat, and I feel like it's very easy to listen to as well. So it's one of those where you can put it on, and you can literally just vibe to it, sort of thing. Yeah.
Great, man.
Beautiful.
Sounds really exciting. We'll keep an eye out for that one. Thank you so much, for coming on. It's been an absolute blast. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that was the Bunker Podcast. Yeah, we've had a good time today. Make sure to drop us a like and a subscribe. Check out his live set that's going to be upcoming soon. It's going to be sick. But yeah, we've had fun as usual. And take it easy. Until next time. Peace out, everyone. See you in a bit.